My name is Josh Fathalahi, and this is your weekly SECBL report. The first round of the SECBL playoffs have come and gone, with the first seed Palm Springs Power besting the Arroyo Seco Sentinels in three games to advance to the championship round. They find themselves in a position that everyone expected to see in a dogfight with the San Diego Force, who won their series with the SoCal Bombers in two games. Before we get into the series recaps, let's take a look at the SECBL Home Run Derby and All-Star Game that took place this week. The biggest bat from each of the SECBL teams participated in the Derby, which included the Power's Caleb Foster, the Sentinels' Devin Durad, the Bombers' Patrick Vizcaino, the Buccaneers' Justin Gomez, and the Force's Joe DeRoche Duffin. Each participant put on a display of power and strength as many homers were launched in front of a healthy crowd here at Palm Springs Stadium. It all came down to Foster and DeRoche Duffin in the end, with the Force's first baseman coming up victorious, smoking four homers and becoming the 2016 SECBL Home Run Derby champion. As for the All-Star Game itself, the Power and Sentinels All-Stars made up Team Freedom, and the Force, Bombers, and Bucks All-Stars made up Team Independence in what would be a great showcase for all players involved. Various scouts were in attendance to see the cream of the SECBL crop and were not disappointed following the 8-6 victory for Team Independence. The Sentinels' Duncan McKinnon and Gabe Chavez were a menace from the leadoff spot for Team Freedom, scoring two runs and stealing a combined total of four bases. Team Independence had a big four-run sixth inning, courtesy of the Bucks, Kyle Jackson, and Austin Owen, as well as the Force's Derek Nakasoto and the Bombers' Patrick Vizcaino. The pitchers were on their A game as well. Both teams' hurlers tossed a combined 17 strikeouts. Moving on to the playoffs, the Power took 2 of 3 from the Sentinels this week to advance to the 2016 Championship Series. Game 1 was claimed by the Sentinels in a 5-4 thriller in Pasadena. Despite committing four errors, the Sentinels' offense rallied from behind, down 4-3 in the 7th to score two runs and take their lone win in the series. The next game would be closer than the Power would like, but Palm Springs walked off in the bottom of the 9th after Colby Schultz drove in Gilbert Sauceda to keep the Power surging in these playoffs. Game 3 would take place Wednesday night, and the Power closed out the series with a 4-2 win courtesy of a strong performance from Junpei Akinuma, who went 6 1/3 innings, striking out 5 in the process. The Power advanced to the championship round, where they'll take on the San Diego Force. The Force swept their series against the Bombers in two games, winning the first game 6-3 in Pomona and the second game 7-2 in San Diego. All-Stars Nick Zaharian and Carl Schwettman combined for four runs driven in Game 1. And another All-Star, Nick Vautrin, shut the door on the Bombers in Game 2, tossing six innings and striking out three while only walking one batter. The Power and Force begin their final quest for the 2016 SECBL title on Friday at 4:30 p.m. in San Diego. Game 2 and then Game 3, if necessary, will take place here at Palm Springs Stadium on Saturday and Sunday, respectively. I'm Josh Fathalahi, reporting from Palm Springs Stadium.